of 26 years, James Niebauer, said he was cleaning an old shotgun in their kitchen when it accidentally went off.
He thought that it had been held by them.
And I instantly felt the kitchen never wiped it in that.
I knew that there was some terrible trouble,
but I also knew that the state of my parents had just been settled with about 2 weeks before.
Palo Alto police didn't see it that way.
This is how I found out that my sister was that was becoming an accident by the police.
Husband may have accidentally shot Palo Alto woman.
After months of investigating and finding no evidence to the contrary, they closed the case, labeling it an accidental shooting.
It was infuriating because I didn't believe a word of it. I couldn't believe that the police were going to walk away from the case.
I knew exactly.
Lee Sansom heard about Jane through a victim support group, and he wrote her a letter.
After all these years of struggle, it finally appears that I have found someone who knows the ins and outs of the system.
Jane's answer was just what he wanted to hear.
I went to the police department, and I found a detective, and he had really never heard of the case.
She was able to convince me to take a look at the case.
Homicide Detective Mike Yore saw the case as dead.
There's nothing that certainly I can do.
His own department, the DA's office, and even the state attorney general agreed.
I got that. And where Jane Alexander came in and said, you know, not one to accept that.
And I called him the next day. Can you hear again? That's right, Mike. And forever. And said, we get whatever we need. And so finally, he found it was easier just to talk to me and just do whatever we need to do. It's great.
You want that?
Well, I did.
Mike Yore surrendered. Began reviewing James Niebauer's story.
His version of that is he's pointing the gun pretty much directly at her, because she reaches forward to take a look at the gun and it goes off.
Right. But Mike Yore, an expert on firearms, thought there was an important clue in the powder burn left on half of the empty powder smoke. Is there a light bulb kind of moment where you look at it and say, what was that?
There was no powder on the cup. No powder above it.
Which means Abigail Niebauer couldn't have been reaching the gun when it went off. To prove his theory, Detective Yore set up a ballistics test.
This is the weapon that was used in the homicide. The fire engine was got is this is the exact same measurement for a woman that Abigail was accounted to.
The height of the victim. It's 5'6".
So you're trying it from different distances and different arm positions.
Well, we're trying to arrive at an exact replication of the powder strip along the sleeve, size, diameter, and such.
You could not get that powder strip on the sleeve for the arms in any other position other than the defensive position.
Correct. So she's not holding her hands out like this to look at the gun. She's holding her hands in front of her face to see if she's even in the position here when she's shot. Mike Yore's test proved James Niebauer murdered his wife. But he still needed something he could take to court.
You want to present this material to a renowned forensic expert.
Correct.
So that he can corroborate your theory.
Correct.
And the department says,
so this is kind of a weak case. And certainly have enough story and so let's read it. Thank you.
Where's James say in the power of the department does number 9% of John Quarry?
I found a call to Captain and I said, we'll send it.
So they were
sent to Quarry? Absolutely. How much does it cost? We will make a check out to it. And talked to the expert. He spent 3 days there with him. And he absolutely corroborated everything I said.
Finally, 13 years after the death of Abigail Niebauer, James Niebauer was arrested, tried, and found guilty of his wife's murder. Mike Yore proved his case. We stand some next to fight and move on.
And then brought back his healthy brother. It was just incredible.
Lee Sansom knows one thing. It wouldn't have happened without Jane.
Getting justice for Abby was just as much of what was supposed to be getting justice for me first.
And coming up, Jane Alexander is just about to close in on Tom O'Donnell.
Okay.
Yeah. traveling and flexibility now more.
Dad, what are you doing?
No speedy fee, change or cancel any hotel reservation.
No, 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 no,